We have to consider the power scale. In order to consider the power scale, we have to calculate the short circuit power at the normal voltage, and that is calculated using this formula, that is WSN is equal to WSC V by VSC whole square, and WSN, it is the power, short circuit power at the normal voltage, is 680 watt. This length LG is nothing but the WSN. That length AG is nothing but the WSN, that is the short circuit power at the normal voltage. Measure length AG, that length is 9.8 cm, that the power scale is nothing but WSN divided by length AG, so 700 watt per cm. Full load motor output is given 5 HP. Convert that into the kilowatt hour, right? Therefore scale is equal to 37 G 3730 divided by 700 is 5.3 cm. Remember this 5.3 cm scale, right? Now AF represented the total copper loss. AF represented the total copper loss, and in numerical it is given that the rotor copper loss and the stator copper loss are equal. Therefore, the point E is nothing but the midpoint of AF, right? Joint point O dash E, which is called as the torque line. This line is very important. From step 10, we calculated the scale 5.3 cm. Now extend the line GA in vertically upward direction up to the 5.3 cm. Therefore, length X is equal to 5.3 cm. Draw a line parallel to the output line O dash A. Right? Draw a line parallel to the output line O dash A from point X, such that it will cut the semicircle at point A. Now join point OL, measure length OL, and OL is nothing but the full load primary current or the stator current I1. Therefore, I1 is nothing but 7.5 cm, so 7.5 multiplied by 15 ampere is the rated primary current. Draw a parallel line from point L, or draw a vertical downward line from point L, which meet at x-axis at point K. Therefore, power factor of full load is cos phi 1 is nothing but the adjacent side LK divided by hypotenuse OL, and therefore cos phi 1 is 0.853 lag. Now find the maximum parameter. In order to find out the maximum parameter, always draw a parallel line to the torque line or the output line, which will be tangent to the semicircle, and from point of tangent draw a vertical downward. Now in order to find the maximum torque, draw a parallel line to the torque line, which is tangent to the circle at point R. Draw a line from R in vertical downward direction, which will cut the torque line as point A. Therefore RS is maximum torque. Measure that length. Length LN is a full load torque. LN is a full load torque. Therefore length LN is 5.6, and maximum torque divided by full load torque, that relation we have to find out. Therefore that relation is max. T max is equal to 1.875 multiplied by full load torque. Full load slip is equal to MN. Full load slip is equal to MN, rotor copper loss, divided by LN divided by LN, and this LN is nothing but the rotor input. LN is the input, rotor input. Therefore full load slip is equal to 6.25%. Efficiency is the output divided by input. Output is LM, output is LM, and the input is LK. Therefore efficiency is 82.03%. And the maximum output, we know that in order to find the maximum parameter, draw a parallel line which is tangent to the circle. Now to draw a line parallel to the output line and tangent to the semicircle at P, draw a vertical line from P, cut at Q. Length LQ, that is one, length PQ is nothing but maximum output, and measure that length multiplied by the power scale, we will get the maximum output. And HP, that maximum output divided by 735.5 is, you will get the value HP. All other parameter calculations are given in step 23. Just overlook that, and you will get the various parameters from the circle diagram. It is how we can calculate or we are find out the various parameters using the circle diagram. Thank you.